Hi everyone, it's Miranda. I just got back from breakfast. We had pancakes and sausages and cereal and milk and coffee. So it was pretty good. But what I wanted to talk about in a little more detail is the patients that died at the hospital, the ones elderly patients on the 7th floor, and what they put down for the cause of death was Katrina related. That's what they put down. And I've often thought about that, and I thought, you know, that really is sort of ridiculous, because, you know, it wasn't a hurricane, it wasn't a storm that made a conscious decision to take a syringe, to fill it with a lethal dose of medication, and then inject it into a patient. It wasn't a storm that did that. It was a human being that made the conscious choice to do that. So when they put down on the death certificate, or if you hear any discussion about it, and they say, well, the cause of death was Katrina related. No, the cause of death was not Katrina related. The cause of death was four human beings made a decision that the told patients on the seventh floor could be evacuated, but it wasn't killed. That's what happened. It wasn't. What's interesting is that Anna today and her supporters, they talk, when you hear them talk about what happened at Memorial, all they talk about is the horrible conditions, as though that was somehow, okay, conditions were horrible in the hospital, but how is that relevant to the fact that you made the decision to kill a bunch of patients? It's not relevant. To say, oh, the conditions are horrible, therefore we're going to kill you, it's not even a reasonable conclusion. But that's the argument that she and her supporters use, that the conditions are so horrible in the hospital, this is what we did. And as far as I'm concerned, whenever I hear discussions like that, I always think to myself, you know, one of the things that is a fault people is that people don't want to take responsibility for their actions. So they inject the patient with lethal doses of set and morphine, and then they say, oh, well, you know, it was the horrible conditions at the hospital that did it. It's simply ridiculous, and I've heard all of that. It was a conscious choice made by Anna, and she went around and got three nurses who agreed to help her. Two nurses gave lethal injections, and the third nurse was there to make sure that the patient was dead afterward. That's what really happened. I used to work in a nursing home, and the conditions in the nursing home were not very good. In the summer, it got really hot. We didn't really have air conditioning, but we had these fans going. People go to the bathroom on the floor and be left there for a while. And then people would drop their food on the floor and be left there for a while. Sometimes people would go to the bathroom and they'd lay in the bed and go in the bathroom for a while. I mean, those are all horrible things and horrible working conditions. But did I ever think, oh, because of these horrible conditions, I'm just going to kill the patient, and therefore, you know, whatever. And of course not. Of course not. But that's what happened at Memorial. And it's interesting because Anna talked to me a couple times about the media. And she told me, well, she's very angry with the media, and she said that they would never possibly understand what happened at the hospital. But, you know, even though she told me things about the media, the fact that she liked the media, she also used the media when she thought it was to her advantage. I mean, after the verdict came through from the grand jury with no indictment, she held a press conference. I then found out a while later that she had a dinner party or a dinner meeting. She was the guest speaker, and no journalists were allowed into the function. So, you know, she would tell me that the media would never understand if it was to her benefit. She went right ahead and used the media as an example of that press conference. I think the thing that bothers me the most is that I know she's a good person who simply made very bad choices. I think that as time goes by, the thing that I learned from the whole Katrina Poe Memorial Hospital, you know, nightmare, is that what I take away from that is that sometimes very kind and caring people find themselves in difficult situations, and in those difficult situations, they sometimes engage in actions that they wouldn't otherwise engage in. I think that's the main lesson that I've taken from this whole nightmare. I didn't tell you that I was last week. I was back in the emergency of the hospital here in the town that I was in. In fact, it was my arm. See this? I haven't taken it off yet. That's the armband in the hospital. I need to take that off. Why was I in the hospital? Because the doctor said I was a danger to myself, and they wanted to send me back to Eastern, to the mental hospital in the side of the mountains. But I told him that I thought I'd be okay. I had to talk to the psychiatrist so I said, well, I'm going back to this nursing home, I'll see what happens. So he sent me back to the nursing home. But from that, that's basically I heard a new song. A friend of mine, who lives in England, his name is Mark. And he and I are becoming pretty good friends, I think. I really enjoy the time that I get his emails, my email and that. But anyway, he sent me a clip from a group of women in England whose husbands all deployed like Afghanistan, and they got together and formed this choir. And so I got to listen to the song, and I went online because I wanted to listen to more of their songs. And absolutely beautiful. In fact, one of their songs is called Wherever You Are, I think it's called. A really beautiful song. If you have a chance to listen to that, you should listen to it. It's a beautiful song. But you know, all those things, listening to music on my player here, it's my player, and on the back, just gonna put on the back, as you can see it, the fairy. You see what I say? I put a fairy on the back of my MP3 player. But as I said, the thing about Memorial and what happened had absolutely nothing to do with Katrina. Katrina was simply a really bad, being destructive, person, but the decision to kill patients was made by a conscious decision by, a group of people. I'm surprised that when they arrested her, they arrested her on 4 counts of second degree murder. It should have been 4 counts of first degree murder because it was premeditated. I mean, she just didn't think, oh, I'm going to go ahead and kill a patient and kill her. She actually had to plan on what she was going to do. She had to organize, go out and find people who would help her, just to get the medication. It was really first degree murder, premeditated, it was second degree murder. But I worry about Anna because, as I said, sometimes kind people do very bad things. I guess that's about all I'm going to say now. So I'll go ahead and stop, and I'll upload this to my YouTube channel, and you go ahead and take a look at it. Okay, catch you later. Peace.